Hello guys, welcome back to week 4 of the LO18 tournament. Here we have Draystar versus Yerty. They are about to get down with the first warm-up. Not sure who is picking the first warm-up, but I will assume it is Draystar. We are going with Dancing Dolls featuring Cold Kiss, Red Alice remix. I think it's a convert map, likely picked by Draystar. I think Yuri's strategy in this round should be pick as many Nomad maps as possible, because Draystar is really comfortable with that hidden. It'll be a good idea to shift him out of his comfort zone, and maybe he will mess up a little bit and give the opportunity to Yuri to take something back. Draystar is still holding the double S. Oh, never mind. Just as I say it, he just missed twice, in fact. This looks like a really good map to play anytime. Just a warm-up map, we can already see that the two players are really close in terms of skill level. Seems like we're going into another convert pick, which is still a warm-up though. It's a Leave Evanescent, Rohit Extra. I think it's taking quite a while to load up. Here it is. This looks really, really awkward to play. What was that? Such a weird pattern. And despite that, both players were able to get all of it. Imagine how this map looks like on Hard Rock, which is probably a complete disaster. Ooh, the patterns. This map is really hard. Right, both warm-ups are over and we are finally going to get into the actual game. Here they will ban Chino, which is the AR8 CS6 hidden pick. I wonder what Draesar will respond with. Draesar will ban the big black, which is the casual mod, I think free mod pick, and he will enable Chino. I suppose Yerdi is gonna re-ban Chino again. Because there's no way, you know, he's supposed to win that once against Draesar. Yerdi will ban the easy mod, which is I think it's something Ramble, not too sure. But it is one of those maps which is really within Draesar's comfort zone. Hidden is still possible to mess up. And Yerdi going with Wake Me Up double time. I'm very surprised, I did not think he would go with Wake Me Up. I would think you'll go with Sayonara Planet War, or maybe Ende on double time. So Wake Me Up is gonna take a while to load. Hopefully, I'm really hoping that the map actually loads. No, don't start. Wait for it to load, and yes, it loaded. Okay, later I'm gonna private message Yerdy to wait for the map pool to load because the tournament clients always take too long. This should be an okay win for Yerdy considering he must have practiced this map a lot of times. He finds a early miss, but the map is full of choke points. Trey Star still with the double S. The spin clearly is superior on Trey Star's side, but this map with that many choke points hardly matters when it comes to spinners. It seems like Draystar has also already practiced this map quite a lot. The miss. Yerdy has to hope for Draystar to mess up. Otherwise, it's gonna be difficult for him to do anything about it. Draystar finding a miss. This is Yerdy's opportunity to take this map back. And Yerdy has the lead, but it is minuscule. So a single miss will do the job. Or even just the spinners could do the job. Oh, Yerdy missed at the crucial moment. There was such a waste. Feel my way through the darkness, guided by a beating heart. I can't tell where the journey will end, but I know where to start. Tell me I'm and Joey Star is gonna make his pick, which is probably gonna be Chino. Well, life will pass me by if I don't open the eye. Yep, here it is. Yerdy on a back foot. This is probably gonna be a 2-0 for Draystar against Yerdy. Still plenty of opportunities to take back the breakpoint. Yerdy finding the first miss, and in fact he has failed instantly. Draystar holding the double S. Yerdy not too far behind as Draystar misses, but he missed too. still possible to come back. I think Yerdy is slowly giving the point back to Draystar. But it is possible to fail at the end of this song. As long as Yerdy doesn't fail, it is very possible to just win by failure of opponent. However, Yerdy is the one who is failing and couldn't recover. Yerdy finding the huge miss. I think he's not going to pass this one. Or is he? He's gonna pass this one, but the score difference is enormous. 250,000 points of difference. Yerdy is going to go with glorious crown, which is gonna take a while to load again. I hope it doesn't start the map. I think Yerdy is gonna go for a Nomad, and Draystar is either going with Hidden Hard Rock or Hidden. The ending though, so even if you do well, you could fail the ending. And Draystar is indeed going with Hidden Hard Rock, which is a really dangerous pick, considering how easy it is to fail the ending and just fail anywhere, as a matter of fact. Yerdy doesn't even have to full combo, because he can just rely on the very high chance of failure at the end. Both Draystar and Yerdy has missed at the same place. But as you can see the difference when Yerdy missed. You know, he just missed, but when Draystar missed, it's an instant fail, so it's not a fair trade going off in this match. Draystar just crumbling. He's still having the score lead, but he can't just extend this push, that Hard Rock bonus, this far, because he's gonna lose it, and he's just losing it all over the place. Draystar just performing extremely poorly on this map. If he had gone just Hidden instead, maybe he has a chance. Those triplets are just evil on Hard Rock. Draystar is so far behind, I think, sitting on the brink of failure. Still possible to come back if Yerdy just really did really badly. Draystar with the huge miss. Last part, do not fail. And Draystar did not fail, but his score is so horrible on Hard Rock that it doesn't even matter. Draystar's pick 2-1 ahead of Yerdy. Not a very good performance from Yerdy, but an even worse performance from Draystar offsets and gives him the win. Draystar is going with Earthquake, the casual mod map, really old one. Could be dangerous. Depending on whether Yurdi has practiced this enough times. There are a few choke points, for example, one at 400, one at 600 plus, and a few from 800 to 900. So not easy to full combo, but full combo is not what we are looking for. It is just as little misses as possible. Yurdi finding the first miss. Finding the second miss, seems like he's not very comfortable with what he's doing right now. Another miss by Yurdi, so many misses, and yet Draystar is still holding the double S. Never mind, he missed, but Yurdi also missed. So Yurdi is 3 misses behind Draystar. Draystar recovering that 1 miss, but Yurdi giving the miss back. Core difference is 80,000 points. Not easy to recover as Draystar makes one single mistake. Second mistake, but they are really close to each other, so they don't really stack up that much. Around 50,000 point difference possible to recover for Yurdi. But there are no misses to be found on Draystar's side, so how is this gonna work? And Yurdi is the one who finds the next miss. This is pretty much over right now. No chance to come back. Against Yurdi, and it will be on Yurdi's pick. William Tell Overture is the next pick. Here we go. 3-1 for Draystar against Yurdi, and Yurdi making William Tell Overture, which is pretty good considering Draystar must be feeling the discomfort on the Nomad. It may not be enough to win the map for Yurdi just going off of this comfort alone. He has to be himself really comfortable with the map, or at least, you know, more confident than Draystar is. And it seems like that is the case as now, even though both players are doing as well as each other. Dream Star finding the first miss. This map is really short, so misses are not tolerated. Dream Star missing many times. Beauty also missing, but Dream Star is counter missing. The score difference is more than 100,000 points. Ooh, Dream Star failing this section. Is he gonna be able to recover? Oh, Dream Star couldn't recover. He fails. I think he failed. It's not captured on the screen, but I'm pretty sure he couldn't recover at the end. Yep, that was definitely a failure. An excellent pick by Yurdy. And Dream Star gonna pick reset. And ironically, this could reset the scoreline back to 3-3. I mean, pun intended, that is why I said it. But against Yurdy on flashlight, questionable. He could have gone, you know, after school navigators or Laguna on hidden pick. We'll see, this could be a really bad decision on Dreystar's part. If Dreystar gets this one, you'll be sitting on match point. If Dreystar doesn't get this man and give it to Beardy, Beardy will be making the next pick, which could put him on the match point instead. This is the first hard part. I'm gonna see who's the one who's dropping, but nobody is dropping. And this really tough memory section. Both players hitting all of those. Oh, it's a tight game. With Dreystar slightly better in the spinner, but you know, depending on the misses, depending on the droplets, all of these could change. Yurdy finds the first miss, but it is not completely over yet. Dreystar could still miss, but is it too late for Dreystar to miss? I think it is too late for Dreystar to miss. Is he gonna FZ this on flashlight in a tournament? Dreystar does it! He FCs this map on flashlight! Absolutely insane performance! One miss by Yurdy, which is not bad at all, but against an FC with clearly an incredible spin, there is very little Yurdy could do. Wow, Dressed, I have dinner now. What's that supposed to mean? So he's gonna forfeit? What? He wants you need to wait 5 to 10 minutes. Okay, first of all, how are you gonna finish your meal in like 5 minutes? That's kind of weird. So Yuri wants to push in one more map before Dreystar goes for dinner. I think it's the Nega Posse. Okay, it seems like Dreystar is really gone. I think I better contact Yurdy to try to work things out. It seems like we will have to wait for Dreystar to come back from dinner, which is, as he said, 5 to 10 minutes. But sometimes, you know, after eating too much food, you know, you become sleepy. Your concentration is disrupted, your momentum is disrupted. So maybe not a good idea to, you know, put a meal in between a match. For all the viewers right now who's wondering, you know, why there's nothing going on, it's because Razor has went for dinner right in the middle of the match. Not a situation that I would have thought to be able to deal with. But regardless, that's the situation right now. So Joystar said at 18:27 that he's gonna come back from 5 to 10 minutes. Which means if by 18:37 and he doesn't come back, I'll have to, you know, start doing something. Oh, and he's back! Joystar is back! So after the long wait, finally we'll be able to resume our tournament, and Yerdi being really, really respectful, really nice. You know, after seeing Yerdi being so nice, you know, I'm rooting for him now. Like, I want him to 5-4 Joystar right now. And we are going into the 7th map, which is Negapossi. Continued. This is Yerdi's pick, which is a casual mod. He misses first, but maybe that doesn't really matter since the map is like 3 minutes long. Both Yerdi and Joystar are missing, but Joystar are missing a little bit more, so that's gonna give a bit of room for Yerdi to come back. But both of them miss again. Yeah, I think Yuri has a slight combo advantage. It's all up to who misses next. Greystar is the one missing next, so this looks pretty good for Yuri, but his counter missed. This will give the lead straight back to Greystar. Greystar missing once more. Not too sure what's really going on here. Still about one quarter of the map left. Possible for Yuri and Tracer to continue making such mistakes. And the lead goes back to Tracer for some reason. The scores are flickering intensely right now, so it's up to like just accuracy wise, just like one or two droplets. Oh no, here they missed. No, but Dreamstar missed too. Is it going to be enough? No, here they miss again. No. Wonder Yuri to win this, but that was so close. GG, man. And I think the next match is Yuri versus. Oh no, I think Tracer versus Ruby Tick, or Ecker versus Ruby Tick. Yeah, I think it's Ecker versus Ruby Tick. I will see you guys then.